How to recover when you lose everything traveling. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Question I got just the other day. Can you do a demo of what you would do if you were stuck without a PC? What would be your process? I'm sure plenty of travelers have suffered this problem. If you can't solve this, then maybe what else should you carry to help recover your account onto a new mobile in another country? I'm thinking of traveling, but I want to arm myself with info on how to recover. I'll admit, it's an interesting challenge. You're far away from home, and for whatever reason, your wallet, your mobile device, your laptop, everything is all stolen or lost. How do you reconnect to your online life? Now, I went through this as a thought exercise some years ago when my wife and I traveled overseas. My worst case scenario was some kind of incident that had us alive, but with literally only the clothes on our backs. It's a process of bootstrapping, regaining access to one resource that in turn lets you access your other resources, some of which you might need to gain access to everything else. But how do you get into that first account? This kind of bootstrapping does require some thoughtful preparation. You need to answer the question, what do I need to keep? In what account that could allow me to regain access to everything else? For me, for example, that means that one of my many accounts has an encrypted copy of my 1Password emergency kit. That kit, in turn, allows me to access my 1Password vault, containing all the information I need to get back into all of my other accounts. But there's a catch. This bootstrapping account has a strong password and uses two-factor authentication. Even if I remember the password, which in this case I wouldn't since it's a 20-character random password, I still wouldn't have my second factor since it's been lost. How to get started? To begin with, borrow a computer or buy your lost computer's replacement if that's in the plan. I realize that's difficult without a wallet, but bottom line here is you need a computer. If you have only your memory, then there are really only two approaches that come to mind. The first one I'll call phone a friend. As part of the disaster planning for things other than travel, you may have designated a trusted contact to access your information should anything ever happen to you. Well, something just happened. Call them. This requires that you have memorized their phone number, or know enough information to find their number or contact them in some other way. An email address might be enough. Interestingly though, since you don't have access to your own accounts, you'd need to create a new one. And your contact then will get an email claiming to be from you using an email address they've never heard of. Now might be a great time to establish a code word to confirm your identity. Have them give you the appropriate information. The account ID, the password, and possibly a two-factor code in real time, allowing you to get access to that one primary account. Now, the other approach, I'm kind of on the fence about, and you'll see why in a minute, but if the above doesn't work for you for any reason, and you need to be completely self-reliant, then we need to do something else. Have one account that is accessible wherever it is you're traveling, requires only a strong yet memorable password to get in, holds an encrypted file containing the bootstrap information you need. Again, the password should be strong and memorable. I recommend you encrypt using a ubiquitous and easy to get tool like Zip, or a tool you're certain you can find when you need it. This feels icky because only a password protects the account. The good news though is that another password protects your critical information, that of the encrypted file. You need to remember only those two passwords, that of the online account and that of the encrypted file. Now, if you can rely on just a little bit of digital information, things get actually a little bit easier. Remember, relying on your memory or a very trusted friend is that absolute worst-case scenario. One tiny bit of preparation can really make things easier, particularly if you haven't lost quite everything. For example, you might place the encrypted file I talked about above onto a microSD card. You would then keep that in a secret but secure location that is not your wallet, which is easily lost or stolen, or your other digital tools. Same issue. I like the concept of belts that have secret pockets or some other way to make it part of your clothing. My goal would be to have it on my person at all times in such a way that it would not be a target for, say, muggers. As long as you have the clothes on your back, you have access to this important bootstrapping information. And even if it's lost, the contents of that microSD card would be protected by at least one strong password. Now, nothing above replaces the two-factor device, typically your mobile phone, that you may have lost. Not to worry. When you set up two-factor authentication, you were likely given the opportunity to save one or more recovery codes. Make sure that your bootstrapping information above includes these codes. If you don't have these codes, or you didn't save these codes, or whatever, take the time to generate them now. You don't have to be traveling to lose your phone. Alternately, some accounts will have you set up alternate email addresses, which might be used to regain access without two-factor. In a sense, your ability to access this recovery account acts as replacement two-factor authentication. The only catch here is to make sure you're not stuck in a loop where you need account A to authorize account B, but you also need account B to authorize account A. Make certain that you have recovery information or codes or alternatives for two-factor authentication in place, and make sure that whatever information is required to activate them is stored in your bootstrapping information. Once you regain access to the account, be sure to turn two-factor authentication off temporarily until you have a replacement two-factor device you can use. I'm not going to lie. All the preparation in the world may not get you back into some accounts. The example that I'm thinking of is the Microsoft account, unfortunately. Because so many scams and account thefts happen outside of your home country, Microsoft may impose additional security steps to sign in that you wouldn't otherwise see. I've heard from people who, even though they've not lost anything, could not sign into their Microsoft account the moment they tried to from a foreign country. It wasn't until they got back home that they could get back in. While I kind of appreciate the extra security protecting my account, I prefer it not to protect my account from me. But it's important to realize that it can happen. The solution? Well, make sure you have at least one other account that isn't as paranoid about overseas sign-ins. Make sure they have good security, of course, but two-factor authentication, including the ability to use recovery codes, ought to be plenty. And to be clear, while I use Microsoft as an example here, other accounts may be affected by this scenario as well. I don't know of a clear way to tell, other than support forums, perhaps full of people complaining, that it happened to them. Now, I want to touch a little bit on travel documents, because even though it's not technically about getting back into your online world, it's one of those things that can make life a little bit easier when you lose everything overseas. Like I said, you'll have lost everything, and that will include your travel documents. Check with your local authorities for the legality, but I have digital copies of all my important documents stored securely online. That also includes the information about the trip I'm on, as well as identity documents. Now, I'm not expecting your randomly created digital copy of a passport to be accepted as identification. However, it's possible it may speed up the process of obtaining a replacement. At a minimum, for example, you'll know your passport number, and I'd expect your ability to produce an image to be something that might help regardless. So, the bottom line, prepare. Think through the scenarios and decide how concerned you need to be and what kind of information you might want to store where, just in case. Hopefully, you'll never ever need it. But if you do, you'll be very, very glad you thought about it first. Now, before I go, I want to ask you, since I know a lot of people travel, do you have any nifty approaches to solving this problem? It's a hard problem to solve. Let me know. Leave a comment below and we could all learn something from your experience. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177198. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.